for everyone who doesn't know me, and this is my student project presentation. So the essential question that guided me throughout this project was, how can I expose the Clyde Brown students to different cultural backgrounds, struggles, and points of view through literature that they may not have been exposed to otherwise? So you can see here the aspects of the Millis High School core values and mission statement that goes along with my project are highlighted here in bold. My project aimed to foster the intellectual, personal, and social growth of all of its learners, as well as challenge students to develop increased understanding of themselves as citizens in global society, and make the Clyde Brown students more respectful, responsible, and civic-minded individuals, especially as they go through their adolescence and adulthood. So why I chose this project? First and foremost, I am personally very interested in travel, culture, different places, all that sort of stuff, so I wanted to find a way to take my passions and interests and pass that on to younger students. And obviously, at its core, my project is all about promoting diversity in Millis, and I felt that this is especially important in Millis because, as you can see with this graphic, the population of Millis is around 92% to 93% white, with the second largest racial group only encompassing around 3% of the population. So Millis is a very small, homogeneous town. And so this is all to say that a lot of the children in Millis are only getting exposed to one culture, one outlook, one perspective in their everyday life. And this can promote ignorance, just general knowledge gaps, and fear of the unknown and of differences among people that will really manifest itself later in life. And I also had to look back on my time in the Millis schools. I realized that it took until much later into high school for me to read books by diverse authors and with diverse characters. So that means that I had around 10 years or 9 years of lost time where I could have been being exposed to a lot of diverse individuals and diverse stories, especially at my most impressionable ages. So what I hope to achieve with this project, my main goal of this project was to diversify the collection of books at the Clyde Brown. And I chose books and literature in particular as the way I wanted to promote diversity because, as I previously stated, there is a lot of growth that can be done in Millis through diverse books. But also stories have always played an integral role in society. As humans, we are automatically drawn to stories. Stories are universal. They help us understand our place in the world, and they help us understand other people and their perspectives. And through stories, we are able to find common ground with others, and kids especially are really able to relate to stories like no one else. So it is a perfect opportunity for them to find similarities with someone who looks differently from them and may have a different perspective or background from them. And I chose to work with students at the Clyde Brown because younger children are really invested in their learning and education and they want to learn. So I felt that them out of middle school or high school students would really get the most out of this project. And one of my longer term bigger goals was just to increase empathy with the children in the Clyde Brown. Because again, like I said, children have a really easy time relating to stories. So this allows them to put themselves within the shoes of someone else. Causing them to develop the skills of understanding what others are also feeling. So before I was able to do anything, I of course had to contact Mrs. Django, who is the principal of the Clyde Brown, and Mrs. Nolan, who is the director of the curriculums at all of Millis Public Schools. And I just told them kind of what I wanted to do, what my plan was, just so I could alert them of what I was doing and have them be on board. And once I got their permission, I started to compile a list of books, some of which you can see here. And I also decided that I wanted to work with kindergartners, first graders, and second graders, similar to what I said before, I wanted to work with the younger kids. And when compiling my list of books, I really wanted to encompass as many different groups of people as possible so I could have a really well-rounded group of books. So you can see here I have stories that include African American, Indigenous, LGBTQ, disabled, Japanese, all different types of people. So I had a little shift in plans about halfway through my project because I was kind of ghosted by some people at the Clyde Brown, so that kind of put a wedge in my project and it made me really feel lost. lost and I kind of floundered for a while because I wasn't exactly sure what to do. But I had a talk with Mrs. Boise and she said that working with the Clyde Brown Library would be a great way to push my project because I had originally planned on working with the curriculums over at the Clyde Brown, and she made it clear to me that working with the library would be a lot more of a practical option for me. And it was eventually a plan that I really loved and really enjoyed, so I'm so thankful for Mrs. Boise for that. So after my talk with Mrs. Boise, she got me into contact with Mrs. Doherty, who runs the libraries over at the Clyde Brown. And I had a meeting with her and it was super helpful. She gave me multiple different options for where I could take my project. But eventually we kind of settled on we split it up into three main parts. One of which was to just go through their library collection and eliminate any books that I deemed were unfit or just not great for today's world. And then I would take my original list and upload it onto a program called Tidal Wave, which I'll get to later. And then I could do a read aloud for a class. So first and foremost, every day after school for a couple of weeks, I would go over to the Clyde Brown and just read through their library collection and get rid of any books that were unfit and put books on display that I thought were really awesome examples of diversity, which you can see here. And actually in the Clyde Brown, they don't have one library. So I worked with primarily the first and second grade library and just went through their whole collection. And this is an example of a book that I took out of circulation. It's Ollie and the Magic Stew. Now, obviously this is a children's book, so on face value, it doesn't look like there's anything wrong, but the imagery and the story of this is actually a classic example of Orientalism. For those of you who don't know, Orientalism is basically the representation of Asian people, Asian cultures, especially people from the Middle East, in a very stereotyped way and just kind of is regarded as embodying a colonialist attitude. So as you can see through the imagery, it kind of shows Eastern people and Eastern culture as being completely different from those of the West. And just popular examples in mass media would be Aladdin or some of the Indiana Jones' movies. So this is just really not what children these days should be exposed to. And Mrs. Doherty said that when they made the move over to the Clyde Brown, she had originally gone through a lot of the books and gotten rid of any that she deemed were unfit. And I have to give a lot of praise to her because I went over there countless days and I only found about two or three books that I had to get rid of. So she did an incredible job with that. And also I noticed how many awesome examples of diverse books they have right now in the Clyde Brown, which is a stark contrast from when I was there. So I'm very happy that the kids now have the opportunity and have these books at their disposal, and a lot of that is because of Mrs. Doherty. So the Tidal Wave list. So I originally got all of my books from this blog right here, theeverymom.com, and it was just a list that she made of 50 books that kind of encompassed what I want to do with my project. It's just a list of 50 great diverse books that tell awesome stories. And then it's kind of blurry right here, but I just made a list of 10 books that I really loved out of that list, wrote what they were about, why they fit my project, and I shared that with Mrs. Doherty. And I uploaded all of those books onto Tidal Wave, which is a program that just has basically all of the books you could imagine in one spot. So I added them to a list that she shared with me. She had access to it, and it showed the books and their prices. So they came to around $200, a little more than that. And we had originally planned on doing a Park Street Books fundraiser for it, but she actually found funding that she got from last year from a fundraiser that she chose she wanted to use for the books. And I didn't know this, so this was a wonderful surprise that I had that I didn't need to fundraise, so that was great. And so with each of the books that I chose to incorporate into the library, I made just small little activities for them. So one, the teachers could incorporate into the curriculum. So they would have a book and they would have an activity to go along with it. And these activities are very simple. They're just asking one or two questions, a drawing activity. And their main purpose was just to kind of reinforce any of the topics that the books demonstrated to the kids that they may have glossed over. And then probably my favorite part of the whole project was I was able to do a read aloud for Mrs. Ball's first grade class. I chose to read the book Pink is for Boys. And this is an awesome book that just kind of goes through all the colors, shows that, you know, pink isn't for girls, blue isn't for boys. Everyone can enjoy whatever color they want, no matter who they are. And it was such an incredible experience because the kids were awesome. They were so engaged. They answered all of my questions. They participated in reading. They were really as good as they could have been. And it was really awesome to see that a book that I picked out, kids really enjoyed. So it was a really incredible experience. So some of the successes that I had, my main goal from day one was that I wanted to include books into the playground, and I did that, so that was awesome. And what I didn't think I was going to be able to do, but I did, was I eliminated books that kids shouldn't be exposed to anymore, so that was also a really great thing. And this doesn't go along with my project too much, but I got to reconnect with old teachers that I had. I had Mrs. Ball as a first grade teacher, so that was awesome to be able to go back and reach in her class, and also just spending a lot of time at the Clyde Brown. I was able to reconnect with some of my old teachers, tell them about my project, and they were really excited about it, so that made me feel really good. And also connect with the students at the Clyde Brown, that was really awesome, so I could see kind of who my books are going to affect and really how they enjoyed it. And probably my biggest success was that I finished the project. There were multiple times throughout the year that I was not convinced that I was gonna finish it, so that was a huge success. Some struggles, really staying on top of things, especially at the beginning of the year, college application season, classes, homework, all of that. I pushed the project to the back of my mind, and I had to realize the hard way that if you forget about a project, that doesn't mean it disappears. It's still there, you still have to work on it. So that was something that I had a hard realization. And then working past obstacles, obviously my emails going unanswered was one of the biggest obstacles that I had, and it kind of affected me, but days kept going by, so I had to just keep on working with it. Then reflection, this project definitely taught me how to manage a large project that I think that will benefit me as I go into college and later in life. And it also made me so happy to see that there were so many great books out there that children have at their disposal that I didn't have. And it's a great note that middle school and the high school can take, that there's so many books out there that we should all incorporate them into all curriculums, no matter the grade level. And also don't be afraid to ask for help. There were so many times during this project where I probably should have asked for help when I was struggling, but I didn't, and now I know that probably I should have asked for help. Big thank yous to Mrs. Bartley for being my mentor, Mrs. Boise for helping me out and changing my project a little bit, and Mrs. Doherty and Mrs. Ball for allowing me to go into the Clyde Brown and help out. That was a really great experience. This is my work cited, and I'm really appreciate it.